announce for anybody who's interested in coming to church. We'll be back on Wednesday night at 7:30. 6:30 is our prayer time. Amen. When we get a hold of God and find out what he wants us to do with our lives for this congregation, for all that God is doing here in the Northeast, let's believe God together. We'll be in prayer at 6:30 on Wednesday night in our midweek service. Saturday, we'll be on outreach again, sharing the love of Jesus Christ with people here in Greece and in Gates, amen, in all of Rochester. And then we're believing God to use our lives and use our influence and use our testimonies and watch what the grace of God can complete as we labor, amen, as we fervently believe, God, that Jesus is coming back and coming back soon. And not only soon, but quickly, in a moment's time, amen. We want to warn people. We want to encourage them to live for God and let them know of the reality of Jesus Christ in our lives also. Sunday morning, we'll be back, amen, at 10 o'clock for adult Sunday school. 10:30 is our morning worship. 6:30 is our evening service. And 5:30 is prayer, amen. I also want to take note of the 2021 Northeast Bible Conference in Cape Cod, Massachusetts, in Hyannis, hosted by Pastor Paul and Linda Campo. And then the guest speakers are Jeff Day and Kevin Flea. You have a shot of that? By chance?
Right there.
Very good. And we want to invite you to that. Take note of that. And maybe plan to spend the week there. Amen. God will richly bless you. Let's change the order of our service. And I would like to take our offering, amen, for the Greece Potter's House. If you're listening online, you can click the link and make your donation or pay your tithe. And for those here, we're going to pass the basket in a minute so that you can invest in eternity. Amen. This is called the Cities for the Levites from Numbers 35, verses 1 through 5. And the Lord spoke to Moses in the plains of Moab by the Jordan across from Jericho, saying, command the children of Israel that they give the Levites cities to dwell in from the inheritance of their possession. And you shall also give the Levites common lands around the cities. They shall have cities to dwell in, and their common land shall be for their cattle, for their herds, and for their animals. The common land of the cities which you shall give the Levites shall extend from the wall of the city outward 1,000 cubits all around, and you shall measure outside the city on the east side 2,000 cubits in the south side 2,000 cubits and on the west side 2,000 cubits and on the north side the same. The city shall be in the middle, and this shall belong to them as common land for those cities. The Levites was the tribe that were in charge of the tabernacle. They were in charge of the things of God. And they were, as it were, the priests of the children of Israel as they were sojourning in the desert wilderness. I want you to know that God makes provision for the priests and also the shepherd leaders. How much more should God be providing for his house as you and I are enjoying Greece Potter's House? Amen. Me and my wife do not take a salary, although we are laboring here because we love the work. My family and I have been serving this church and serving this community, although we do not really expect any money or recompense or payment. Amen. We're doing this. Amen. But still, we need to give to the work. We have to pay for our lights and our building and the flyers and all the evangelism that is incurred in the work. And we want you to know, here's an opportunity for you, amen, to invest in souls, to invest in what God is doing, amen. When you pay your tithe, amen, that's going to come back on you and that's going to bless you, amen. Can I have the usher come forward, amen. Let's give to God and make provision for what's going on here, amen, in evangelism and what God is doing here. Hallelujah. Thank you. I'm going to ask Brother David to pray over the offering, amen, that God is glorified here in Greece Potter's House.
Amen, Lord. see you work in the near future.
Amen. Lord bless you. Thank you for your giving. Thank you for your faithfulness.
Amen. And giving online too.
To the assembly. Amen. And thank you for your giving tonight. Amen. We want the Lord to bless you. If you brought your Bibles, you can turn to 1 Corinthians 3. We're going to read one verse and look at that tonight. We're going to look at the value of laying down a lasting foundation in our lives. Amen. This first illustration to open up the service is a location in modern-day Rome. It's near Fidenae, I believe. There's no cost associated with this building project. It was built around 27 AD. But the issue was that there was a rushed construction and an untested integrity. And the date of the incident was 27 AD. Ancient Rome was famous for bloody gladiator fights. But one of the most horrific disasters in history had nothing to do with the combatants that were on the ground. One notable venue for gladiator games was the amphitheater erected in Fidenae at the bidding of an entrepreneur named Attilius. Despite his wealth, he aimed for a quick construction over a sturdy one. According to some sources, he urged the builders to use cheap materials, mainly wood, to build the stadium, and it was erected on unstable foundations. Most of the information about the disaster comes from ancient texts, such as the one by Tacitus and by Tiberius, but they tell of a singular story. When 50,000 people had flocked to Attilius' stadium to watch a gladiator fight, 20,000 of the audience members fell to their death as the seating collapsed. And many of the remaining patrons were severely injured. Let's look, following the instrument, the Senate banned anyone from building a stadium unless their wealth had exceeded 40,000 sesterces, which I figured out was about $1.3 million. And the stadium had to pass a series of safety inspections. So let's look at the value of laying a lasting foundation for our lives tonight from 1 Corinthians 3, verse 11. For no other foundation can anyone lay that which is laid, which is Christ Jesus. Amen. This is called a foundation laid. For we are God's fellow workers, and you are God's field, or God's building. And Paul gets into this whole illustration about the building process and the foundation that is laid, which is Christ Jesus. Amen. We're building our lives according to the grace of God, verse 10, which he has given to me, a wise master builder. Paul is saying, I have laid the foundation, and another builds on it. But let each one take heed how he builds. This is for you and I tonight. As we are struggling to find our way through life, we're making decisions, we're making choices, we're choosing our friends. We are involved in ministry in the greatest enterprise that has ever been created, and that is the building of this church. Amen. And you are making choices about what job you're going to do, who you're going to marry. You are building on one decision after another. Amen. Verse 12. Now, if anyone builds on this foundation with gold, with silver, with precious stones, wood, hay, and straw, each one has a work that will become clear, for the day will declare it, because it will be revealed by fire, and the fire will test each one's work. What sort it is, if anyone's work which he has built on it endures, he will receive a reward. If anyone's work is burned, he will suffer loss, but he himself will be saved, yet as through fire. Do you not know that your body is the temple of God? Amen. And the Spirit of God dwells inside of you. If anyone defiles the temple of God, God will destroy him, for the temple of God is holy. Which temple you are, he's referring to. Yeah, the body. You're not supposed to be injecting heroin through a needle into your veins. You're supposed to be taking care of your body. You're supposed to not be living an immoral life. You're supposed to be careful about your diet. But more importantly, the temple of your life, my friend, the way that you're going about building your life and what you believe is critical. And that building on Jesus, of course, is the first and foremost thing that we need to make preeminent in our lives. That foundation. The thing that determines the real strength be hidden. It's below your life. It's out of sight. Is the foundation of everything that is built on top of it. The unmoving, settled, completely source. Amen. Of all that you are tonight, what makes our lives eternal and unshakable, amen, is a solid substance, and it is the person of Jesus Christ. If you're a friend of mine building on any other foundation that is not Jesus, amen, your building will certainly topple, it will crumble. And you will, amen, watch it when the storms of life, the surge of the waves compounding on your life, amen. If it's not built on a solid foundation, amen, it will certainly suffer great loss. Amen. That's why it's critical. Our parents laid a foundation in our thinking. Amen. Through our development as children, some of you had parents that implanted a good, solid work ethic inside of you. They didn't stop working. Sometimes your dad, he would work 3 or 4 jobs just to make ends meet in your family. Other ideas that might have been taught to you and ingrained within your thinking was that families stick together. And then even if they're wrong, we're still going to go rumble, man. You don't say that to my sister or whatever. Sometimes, amen, there's battles to be fought that are worth it. Let's look at a couple of these things that my mother taught me. Some of you might have read this. My mother taught me about the weather. Your room looks like a tornado hit it. My mother taught me about religion. You better pray that comes out of the carpet. My mother taught me about time travel. If you don't straighten up, I'm going to knock you into the middle of next week. And last one, I guess we could move on. My mother taught me about osmosis. Shut your mouth and eat your supper. So certain things that we've been taught by our parents, amen, may have been ingrained into our thinking and began to cause us to make certain choices. Amen. Maybe you didn't grow up with a father. Maybe you didn't grow up with a dad and you miss all your life of a father figure. Your mom may have had many boyfriends, people shuffling through your life, but you may be missing that foundational thing that only a father can give you, amen. And that's why, amen, you're making so many bad choices. That's why your life is much destroyed and you can't progress, you can't grow up, you can't mature, you can't keep a job. Many of these things are inside of you and causing you, amen, to fail because your foundation is not weak. You've been crippled. Amen. Our culture also lays a foundation in our morals and in our habits, what your friends are doing. Amen. One guy told me the other day, he said, you know, they're going to legalize pot here. And I said, well, you know what? That doesn't make it right. That doesn't make it moral. Just because the government says, okay, it's okay to smoke weed. Now, look at your motivation. You have no reason to get out of bed because you're high all the time. You don't want to go and work a job. You don't want to press in. You don't want to do anything but smoke weed. And it's not a very good motivator. Our culture says what is right, and we're formed by that. And we let the culture that we live in begin to form us. Amen. And lay a foundation in our thinking. And this is why people are living in sin. They're living immoral. They're sleeping around. They're on Tinder. This is why they can't make any sense, because their foundation is missing. They have a foundation of this world, and it's very confusing. And it's always shifting. Can I hear anybody say amen tonight? Amen. It's a shifting sand. It's not a foundation that is permanent. Amen. This pulpit, there's a certain permanence to this pulpit here, which is good, and it helps me to hold my notes. This one over here is kind of shaky. You need to have something solid as the foundation for your life. And for your life, it's the person of Jesus Christ. Paul tells us here that he is a preacher, he's a teacher, he's only able to help you to build on the foundation, put up the walls, make sure everything's straight, don't use cheap materials, don't use balsa wood for the wall, it's going to fall down. Paul, as a teacher, cannot be a foundation for us. He can only teach us and direct us, amen, how to build our lives. So let's I have said all that. I'm going to start preaching now. This is my first point. This is the need that you and I have for our lives. And that is, amen, to build your life on a solid foundation. Think with me for a minute about the construction process. Anybody ever try to tackle a project in your house? You want to help, you know, remodel or something? It's not as easy as it thinks. I just recently did a remodeling project, and a lot of the things that were done by the homeowner, and everything was crooked. There were things that were done, you know, that didn't really make sense in the regular world. And so I want to look at this construction process very quickly here, because the way things are put together are very important for the longevity of the item. You can make sure that everything is right first and foremost with something called a plumb bob or a level, amen. That makes sure that the walls are up and down, or that anything that is horizontal is not crooked, amen. Meaning straight, sideways, horizontal. You do that with a little bubble. Some people are using this thing that's actually a line laser, which is high tech, and they can do everything with a little device that shoots a laser all around the room at the exact same height. Pretty high tech. Make sure that the corners are 90 degrees. You're using something called a speed square. Amen. You always want to use something to square things up. Make sure it's not 89 degrees, but 90 degrees. Amen. That will ensure that when you get to the end of that portion, that will also be 90 degrees. And you can use glue or nails or screw gun. And you can use all the correct methods that are employed in putting things together. But In a moment's time, it can all come crashing down because there is no foundation. Whether it's a wall, amen, or a roof, or it's a ceiling, or the floor, all these parts of the building are necessary for the function of that building. For its proper function, amen. Without a solid foundation or a substrate that is not moving, amen. You want things on which you're building to be solid in the first place. Because, you know, 20 tubes of liquid nails is not going to be enough to glue it together if what it's attached to is not attached to anything. And we need to look at this process because this has to do with your life. And the way you're building your life up is very important. Everything that has no integrity, amen, without a building on the initial part of the process, it's always foundational. Building your life has to do with the concept of thinking and making choices. One decision will lead to another. Amen. And it's like you're stacking things on top of another. And if you're stacking things and you're going a little bit crooked, pretty soon you're going to have the Leaning Tower of Pisa, my friend. And I didn't say pizza. I said Pisa. Amen. Your thoughts, your actions, your habits, your character, and lastly, your destiny, they're all connected little by little. Amen. You are becoming who you are. Amen. And decisions bring consequences. Amen. This is the building process. Let's look secondly at a solid substrate. That's a fancy word that means what's underneath as you're building on something. Something that is not going to move. And you want something that is fixed or unchangeable. Something that can handle the weight and the stress and the power of force that is against it. Like this building, I don't know, I can bring your attention to this post over here. I wrapped it in some 2x6s or 2x8. But behind that and inside of that column is a post of metal. And it is holding up the entire half of this building. I mean, plus the strain that is on the exterior walls. There's a second post in the other building, I think the other half of the building that we share. But without those, amen, this ceiling, this roof, I don't know how many tons it's up there, but that would crash on our heads. And your hat wouldn't really protect your brain, my friend.
You're right.
It would crush right through you. So there has to be some integrity here, and we have to look at the way that things are fixed, something that can handle the weight of our lives, something that can handle the force or a power that's against us. A solid substrate or a foundation, amen, is necessary for every building project, amen. Some of you might hear this platform that I'm preaching on. Amen. I didn't build this out of balsa wood, but I followed some direction from a friend, a construction guy, who said you need to get those metal studs. There's a certain gauge to them. I had to go out to Henrietta and pick them up, but they're all 16 on center here. This is pretty solid, and it's up to code. There's 3/4-inch plywood on there. Otherwise, I would try to walk up here, and my foot would crash right through if it was 3/8 plywood, you could say. And life is no different, amen, for you and I. We have to understand the critical element in the process is found and established at the beginning of your life. And at the beginning, that's why it's so wonderful to be a Christian, amen, because each and every day God is merciful to us. We can wake up. We can start things over if we've blown it in the past. Amen. We have an opportunity each and every morning to start over with brand new decisions. Amen. There will be things in your thinking that, amen, will, disable you or be a disability and will kind of follow after you. You're going to have to shake them loose and start with a real unshakable foundation, and that is Jesus Christ. And everything else is directly or indirectly affected by that foundation. The lowest load-bearing part of the building, typically below ground level. Here is something that's not visible to the naked eye. You couldn't tell me from a CEO of a company, or or I could be a Christian. You know, it's not the way I look, but it's really something inside of my thinking, amen, that makes me who I am, that you really can't see. You weren't there on Halloween night 1986 when I was at a bar and some guy started preaching to me, gave me a tract, said I could make heaven my home, I could start my life over. You weren't there on that day when I repented of my sins in the church service and I cried like a baby. Amen. Those were foundational things in my life and my experience, amen, that shaped me and made me who I am today. I'll never forget those things. That was Jesus. Something that's not visible to the naked eye. Something hidden within my life. Amen. As an underlying basis or principle. Secondly, a basis, that foundation is a starting point. It's a point of departure or a premise. It's never evident. It's never plain to the eye. But the endurance of what it's built on is clearly seen in my life 34 years later. Some people, they pray at an altar, they pray at an outreach, and they feel great. And they might even come to church for a time. But something happens in the process of life where they're not building on Jesus. They're building on their own concepts, their own religious ideas. And this is what takes them out. And we see them. Their building is toppled over. Their walls are crashing in. There's rust everywhere. The siding is split. And the roof is flying off in the wind. Nothing good is happening in their lives. Amen. And their life is crashing down, thirdly. Tonight, if your life is crashing down, amen, let's look at that idea for you, amen, in your life. It's falling apart. It's likely, more than likely, that your foundation is flawed or there's a crack in the middle of the foundation and things are shifting. Although you've had the best home life, maybe you were brought up in a great house. Maybe you've had a decent education. And, maybe you didn't go to, you know, Disneyland or whatever, but you had a good life, good experiences growing up. And then you've had plenty of bills to pay the money. You know, you haven't been in want. Most people here may have had experiences of failure in the following ideas, and that is in relationships and, or addictions. Maybe you're in a bondage right now and you're suffering. Everything is going to be lost in your life because you give yourself to that sin or to that drug or to that habit. That habit is destroying your life. It's controlling you. Maybe you have certain harmful mindsets that you can't break through. You always come back to the same old thing over and over again. These are problems. These are failures in your life. Maybe you're not good with money. I'm just not good with money. Well, that's a serious problem, my friend. And you can address it tonight because your life is crashing down. You don't know how to steward or manage your finances because you have a weak foundation. Maybe you have no foundation. What is the financial? I want to ask you a few questions here. It looks like a lot of question marks. What has been the foundation of your life? Is it your spouse? Are you building your life on, your career or, your charisma or your personality, your talents? Amen. building on truth. Amen. This is completely different, building on truth. Have you been making decisions with a valid and a wise view of life? So what is the end goal of your existence? Are you just trying to get by? You're just trying to get from paycheck to paycheck or from day to day? Just rolling through life, you're just getting by, just putting forth a little bit of effort? Or are you avoiding challenges and things that are honorable? Amen. God is calling you and I to higher ground. He's calling you and I, amen, to fight and to set free the captives. Amen. He's calling you to a dignified life. Amen. But you choose to settle on sand. You're building your life on things that are not good. Things that are shifting, the shifting sands of culture, the shifting sands of just what the society that we live in is saying, this is good for now, things that are trending. I want to look secondly at building on something that is more dependable, and that is upon Jesus, or else everything will fail in your life. Everything's going to fall, my friend, unless your life is built on Jesus. Because Jesus is rock. Jesus is unchanging in your life. Jesus is, he's the one thing, amen. His sayings, amen, are eternal. We can build our lives upon the rock. Everything else is sand. The world, yourself, the devil, and philosophy, there's religion, plenty of religion out there. But it's all sand, it's shifting sand. Matthew 7, 24. Therefore, whoever hears my words and my sayings and does them, I will liken him unto a wise man who built his house upon the rock, and the rain descended and the floods came and the winds blew and beat on that house, but it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. And anyone who hears these sayings of mine but does not do them, I should liken them unto a man who builds his house upon sand. The sand, amen, is not a good foundation. The rain descends, the floods come, winds blow, beat on the house, and it falls. It's ruined. And when you build on things or ideas or concepts that are shifting and temporary, amen, you're building on your feelings. Our generation many times is so guided and directed by what their friends say and by the opinions of other people that they're crushed when they see on their Twitter account or their Instagram, people are talking junk about them, and they want to cut themselves, they want to kill themselves, they're so depressed. People are so emotional these days, amen. You can feel it when you're out in public too. There's the race thing, that people aren't settled in that. There's things, you know, put your mask on, your mask is slipping down. They're all uptight about a lot of things, amen. Amen. You will experience failure, sorrow, and disappointment. Amen. What did James say? Count it all joy when these things happen. That's kind of a radical thought. When God is pressing you to grow and to glorify Him and to believe Him, amen. Things are going to happen even to the Christian. Life happens to all of us and hits us really hard, amen. It's destructive. It beats on us, amen. But when Jesus is the rock, amen, you will sometimes go through those same kind of trials and painful experiences, but you can be sure that when you build on Jesus, amen, and his sayings and his doctrine, his teaching, that you will, amen, survive, and more than survive. What did Paul say? We are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Amen. And building on Jesus, because he is a rock. He's unmovable. He's solid. He's persistent. He is consistent. Matthew 7:26. But everyone who hears these sayings of mine and does not do them. Amen. The house falls, and great was its ruin. Following truth means that you will not be surprised in the end. And then if you decide, if you choose tonight to ignore what I'm saying, that's fine. You're not going to hurt my feelings. Amen. But in the end, you should not be surprised, because I have warned you what's going to happen to your life, because you have rejected building your life upon the foundation of Jesus. And those who have chosen to put their full confidence in Christ, amen, will not be disappointed, amen. You will find that this is the best way to live, amen. Personal integrity keeps you together and holds up your life, amen. Secondly, our obedience and actual faith brings that integrity, amen, to our lives. Amen. When you're building on the realities of truth, amen, you are going to be rewarded as you're searching for God, as you're hungering and thirsting and wanting God to help you, amen. He is going to reward you. Building your life on Jesus' sayings, secondly, ensures us that even in life's most difficult trials, the Christian can stand strong. Amen. You believe that tonight, don't you? Amen. Disobedience to truth or following the lies and the deception will only lead us to build on sand, and eventually that will be a great tragedy, because this world is only temporary. Worldly ambitions, amen, will be there, and things that are based on feelings and emotion will just dissipate. They will just float away. There's nothing of value to them, nothing lasting, no quality to that kind of life. Amen. I'd like to close with the foundation laid, and that is John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and nothing was made that was made without him. In him was life, and his life was the light of men. So let's study this for a minute, because Jesus is eternal. Amen. We have a sure foundation to build our lives upon. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And when we're building on him, we cannot fail. Our lives are solid, amen, because we have him for a foundation. Amen. You can have the wisdom of the world. You can try to put all your ducks in order. You can have all your retirement set up and everything focused on your business or your career. Amen. But what's going to happen in the end after you die? Amen. Our lives are solid only because of our foundation as Christians are on Jesus Christ. In his sacrifice, our sins are forgiven. In his truth, we believe on his power. And he is supreme over all other principalities, powers, and rulers. Amen. Colossians 1:6, for by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are in the earth, visible, invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through him and for him. And he is before all things, and in him all things consist. Amen. This is the supremacy of Christ. Revelation 1:8. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, says the Lord, who is and who was and who is to come. I am the Almighty. Amen. This is the supremacy of Christ. If anyone's work, verse 14, which he has built on it endureth, he will receive a reward. Amen. Building on Jesus is the way that we will succeed. What are the tests of integrity of this building? First is time. That means that you're not going to be a flash in the pan kind of a Christian. Pray the prayer, do the genuflect, forgive me, Lord, and then go off and back into your old life. Time means that you will, there'll be a lasting value to your decision. Amen. What is another test? Earthquakes or fire. Amen. Things will test your life. Your life is going to get shook up a bit. Amen. All spiritual things will be tested to see if they can withstand fire. Because fire proves the integrity of it. If it's a wood, or if it's straw, or if it's stubble, if it's balsa wood, it will certainly crumble, fail, and burn up in the end. But gold and precious metals are always purified by fire. Amen. Let's look at C.T. Studd for a second here. When asked at a meeting, he said, the people said, C.T., listen, why are you going to be an event? Why are you going to go to become a missionary in Africa? Why are you going to leave your family? They thought they had cornered him because it, even his family was saying, you're crazy. I mean, his brothers and his sisters and his mom and his dad. C.T. Studd said, if Jesus be God and died for me, then no sacrifice can be too great for me to make for him. Amen. Life's purpose. Only one life, he said. It will soon be past. What's done for Christ will last. Amen. Let's close momentarily here. And the location is Pisa, Italy. The cost, they don't know how much they paid for this thing. It was constructed in 1173 to 1372. That's a long time for building this thing. But the issue was it had a poor foundation. Any ever hear of the Leaning Tower of Pisa? The date of issue is 1378. The most famous of structural failures has to be the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Situated behind Pisa Cathedral, known also as the Tower of Pisa, the tower was originally built to house the bell of the complex. The tower was built on an entirely unstable foundation. An altogether too small limestone base of only 3 meters deep. Let's guess that's about 10 feet, right? A meter's like a yard, I'm guessing. Into a dense clay bed, which meant the tower was never going to last. Only 3 levels of the plan, 8 were completed by the time a war broke out between city-states, which gave the foundation time to settle, possibly preventing a collapse while the building continued. Only 5 years after the completion, the tower started to achieve its now famous lean, slanting at nearly 10 degrees. Only in the 90s did authorities deem action necessary, adding 600 tons of counterweights to bring it back to perpendicular. Of course, the tower's lean is made into a beloved tourist attraction. So maybe it all wasn't a failure after all. Let me ask you this in closing. Do you want your life to tip over? Or do you want to look like something silly? A building that is leaning. You're saying you're a Christian, you're like about to fall over. But maybe it's time to start your life again, amen, with a new foundation, a real foundation that will never move, never fail, and always be true. Let's bow our heads, close our eyes, amen, in God's presence. I want to thank you for being faithful to our service, amen. And if there's somebody you're not saved, or you're backslidden, amen, I want to pray with you. You're online. And Jesus has died for your sins. And if you put your trust in him, amen, he will never fail you. He will never give you the slip up. He will never lie to you or deceive you, amen, because he is the truth. And Jesus is the way, amen. He's your life. Why don't you pray with me? If you're not saved, or you're backslidden, and pray this prayer of me. Say, Jesus, I know that you're not in my life, and I have disrespected you, I ask for forgiveness. I thank you for the cross and the suffering that you took for me, the bondage that I am released from now. I thank you that you have given me everlasting life. I thank you for your blood that you shed on the cross to pay for my sins, to release me from that debt. And I'm asking for a miracle. I repent of my bad choices and my neglect of our relationship. And I'm going to serve you today and every day for the rest of my life. I thank you for your sayings. I thank you for the foundation. In Jesus' name, amen. And perhaps you prayed that prayer tonight. I'm going to encourage you to start reading your Bible. If you need a Bible, we'll be glad to give one to you. Come to church on Wednesday night. Amen. And watch what God will do with your life as you build on a foundation that is sure. A foundation that's not cracked, my friend. A foundation that's not only 10 feet deep. Amen. And Jesus' words are eternal. Amen. He is going to help you and save you and give you miracles. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's change the order for the Christian. Amen. Building on Jesus, amen, is the only way to ensure an endurance to your life. Amen. I didn't even talk or really get into the qualities of building your life, the materials that you're using. But I want you to think about that. And we're going to open up the altars right now for God to do a work in your heart. Amen. Let's sing this song with our sister. What a beautiful name it is.
God, I thank you for your foundation and all that you accomplished. I believe you, Lord God, that you're going to, amen, help these Christians, Lord God, to focus on the real things. And God, give us sinners, precious sinners that you have died for, Lord God, that they would build their lives upon you, Lord, and they would not be shaken, they would be strengthened and powerfully established because of who you are.
good to be in the house of God. Thank you for coming. Your faithfulness, amen, to this work, amen. If you join us online, we'll be here on Wednesday night at 7:30. David, can you please pray for us as we leave?
Yeah, we thank you, Lord, for giving us some food as we go out this week. We thank you, Lord, that we can go out knowing that you're in us and with us, knowing that you're always there to help us, to protect us, to guide us. And we thank you for the comfort of that, Lord. We know that we couldn't do it without you, and we thank you that you would never leave us alone. So we thank you, Jesus. Show us what to do, where to go, and who to talk to. In your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Have a great week.
I was there the moment that it happened, but you couldn't see me through the pain. I caught every tear as they were falling when you lost your heart that day. Yeah, you lost your heart that day. Now you only see through broken lenses, trying to keep your head above the